Kia ora. It's been once again a busy month. I'm starting to wonder if there are ever going to be any quiet ones. Budget week, of course, is the biggest week traditionally of the parliamentary year, and it's fair to say it was fairly contentious by my constituents in the North Shore. I met with a group of principals who were very exercised about some of the measures, but we sought clarification, and there have been, in my view, some very good adjustments around that. And now the intermediate schools, the year 7 and 8, are only going to be losing at an absolute maximum up to 2 full-time equivalent teachers, and there is a contingency fund. So often these things are not quite as bad as they first appear. On balance, I feel it is a very fair budget for these times. It is our second zero budget. We're trying not to spend, and we're finding savings from all over. I'd have to say that with the health budget, we have the renal unit at the North Shore Hospital now. There are something like 27,000 more elective surgeries than there were when we took over in 2008. That's about 500 extra a week. These are the kind of things that really, I think, impact very much on our lives. In terms of my North Shore activities, I've begun, and they've been very successful so far, Mondays with Maggie. I meet in cafes throughout the electorate, from Mairangi Bay to Devonport. So I basically take up a table in a cafe. I have appointments for my constituents, and we talk about the things that concern them. Wellington on-ramp's been a bit of a horror story. A lot of people are very worried about the amount of time and delay it takes because that off-ramp has been closed for nearly a year. It's very good to see that Transit New Zealand are starting to do a little bit more work around that. There's some more urgency. I'll certainly be keeping a watch on it. With Devonport, the community gardens have been a major issue as well. And of course, we have the Māori settlements going through, which is going to affect the Narrow Neck area and Ngāti Whātua or Rākei. That's probably going to be coming up next month through the House for its next reading. I guess for me, as a local member of Parliament, I'm very aware of the community events in Rosmini. Congratulations on the 50th Jubilee. That's really been wonderfully well celebrated for this excellent school. Westlake are also doing very big commemorative celebrations too. We have a wonderful standard of education on the North Shore. From my perspective, when I'm here in Parliament, in my parliamentary office, the mixed ownership model has been the chief preoccupation of my Select Committee of Finance and Expenditure. And in local government and environment, we're dealing with the exclusive economic zone, which has also been contentious, and there's certainly no support from the Greens or Labour. The only sort of drilling that they're fond of is the idea of drilling down into the detail of the bill and imploding it. The very notion that we might explore our options is an alien thought. So it's going to be a very lively series of debates in the House before the exclusive economic zone comes back to Select Committee. So all in all, as your MP, I'm working hard on your behalf, and if you ever need to get hold of me, please do. All of my details as to what I'm doing are on my Facebook and website, and also, of course, my details about how to get in touch with me here in the Wellington office or my team in the North Shore office. And I would welcome any feedback from you, and it'd be great to see you at Mondays with Maggie.